Hello, Comp 2. I just wanted to take a few minutes to record, hopefully, a helpful explainer video, as we are a few weeks into the semester, and you've been introduced to pretty much everything that you're going to need for the rest of the semester in terms of the kinds of assignments we're going to be doing, and a couple of really long-term assignments that are going to see you through the first half of the semester, the entire semester. And then in class together, we started practicing literary analysis, which is going to be the common thread throughout the entire semester and really our focus in the last half of the semester after your research essay has been turned in. So I know that the first few weeks of Comp 2 are fairly, perhaps overwhelming in terms of all of the things that are being thrown at you. But hopefully you're feeling a little bit more comfortable. You've gotten the journal underway. You're kind of hopefully this week really narrowing down and focusing on your journal, on your research argument. And after our class discussions last week, feeling a bit more comfortable with the ideas and possibilities of literary analysis. So I'm going to share the screen with you and jump into our Canvas page, just as a reminder of kind of where some things are and where you'll want to be looking. So here we go. And I've set my screen to the student view, so this should be exactly what you see when you log into our Canvas page. So at the top of the page, course details and resources. So the syllabus, there's a YouTube playlist I have. I just basically keep this for my purposes, so there's always kind of a hub for the clips that I like to show you, poetry readings, etc. And then some general writing resources. So the wonderful and terrible thing about the internet is that there is a ton of resources out there for you. That's great, but it can get really overwhelming. So I hope that you always kind of look here for a curated list of, you know, quick and easy links where you know you can trust the information. So here, and a couple of these are new, I just put up yesterday, so I want to show you what they look like. I think this one is going to be very helpful. It's a checklist just for some of the kind of nuts and bolts of MLA style formatting. So now this is up in Canvas for you to look at. So everything from block quotes to in-text citations to the works cited page, this should just be really, really helpful for you to make sure you're kind of hitting all those marks. With the very kind of black and white part of writing, where there are some pretty strict rules and regulations. You want to be comfortable with this and make sure that you are structuring your papers the right way so you can focus on the good stuff, which is the critical and creative thinking. That's where I want your energy to go. So making sure that you have these, again, the nuts and bolts in place is really important, but you want your energy to go to the good stuff. This is one of my absolute favorite handouts. It's one of the things that, and we'll be talking about this more, especially as you start writing your research essay. Integrating quotations into your writing is one of the things that students, it's a simple mistake that is made quite often, but it's really easy to fix. So if you look over this handout, just a page and a half, wonderful examples of how you don't want to let quotes stand alone. They can't stand alone. They have to be supported by your voice and sandwiched within your introduction and analysis to these quotes. So please utilize this handout as well. 10 common writing errors. Just at this point in your writing career in college, we often don't do a whole lot with grammar drills, but we all have our own Achilles heels in terms of things that kind of mess us up. For me, it's lay and lie. I have a hard time conjugating lay and lie, and sometimes I just avoid it. So we all have our own like things that we mess up on. Or like, I'm not sure how to use semicolons, or should I use a dash or a semicolon? So things like that, you wanna troubleshoot at this point in your writing career. So this is a really old, like I scanned this from the first textbook we used in Comp 1 over a decade ago, or that I had used in the classroom. So you can see this is like old school book scanning, but it's just really great these are common errors that people make, that you might be familiar with some of them. And it's just kind of a helpful way to walk through some of those errors. We have gone over the OWL website, and NightSight Citation Service, and then the handbook that's embedded within Canvas, and you can also download it as well. So I know that there are tons of resources online about MLA style or, you know, writing handbooks and common writing errors. Start here, because these aren't incredibly overwhelming and they should give you a lot of the tools that you might need just for, again, general overall writing resources. Next, this module is for the journal. This is where the assignment is. If you are doing a blog, there's a video of kind of how to set up WordPress, but you do not have to do a blog. Most students in Comp 2 elect to keep their journal in a Word document, a Google Doc. You'll just need to turn it into me twice this semester, once mid-semester for just kind of a checkpoint, and then at the end of the semester, you'll turn in the final product. And I'll ask for that as a PDF. So, and just however you keep your running journal, just make sure that you save it and you back it up, because that is an assignment that you kind of keep building on week by week. And again, these are the links. Please go to a number of them. Don't feel like you just have to go to one link. And I'm going to revisit also a point I made in your email, specifically about the research project, but this is where the research project and your journal links kind of intersect. If you go to one of these links, you are just going to get the most recent news stories that they've posted. That doesn't mean that's all you have to look at. You can use the search function to search for interesting stories, to search for things that you're interested in. I encourage you to do that. Don't feel like you are just beholden to the first thing that pops up on any of these links. But hopefully, again, your journal is underway. You should be, so we're starting week 4 of the semester. So you should be starting week 2 of your journal, because again, if you started around week 3, you should be ending it a few weeks before the semester is over. So find a pace that works for you and keep up with it week by week. Eventually, this will be where you turn in the journal assignment as well. I had the final assignment link posted here, but I got some feedback from students that was kind of stressful to see this assignment that's due, you know, 14 weeks from now. So it's not up there yet, but this is eventually where you will turn in the journal as either a PDF or, if you did keep a blog, the URL to your website. The research essay here, and you can already see here, this is where the assignment is, the full assignment, and then you're turning in the small pieces of the assignment one at a time. So this module is where those assignments will live and you'll turn them in. Some research resources. I added a couple of resources just over the weekend that I found to be helpful. But once again, I've curated and provided for you some really kind of basic and helpful links, so you don't feel like you have to kind of get lost in Google trying to find answers. So where we are now is focusing in and narrowing in on your argument. So by the end of this week, you should be ready to present in class and also turn in via Canvas. And it might just be one sentence, but you will be arriving at your claim by the end of this week. So this is an argumentative, you might have heard it referred to as a thesis statement before, or claim, or an argument. I use the term claim most often in Comp 2, whether we're talking about your research paper or literary analysis. The claim you're making is the argument you're making, the point you're trying to prove. So you should be ready to share that by Wednesday or Thursday, and then you'll turn it in just for some quick and easy points on Canvas. It might, again, just be a sentence, but it needs to be clear what you're arguing and what direction you're taking. Hopefully, again, as you've found a couple of students have emailed me, and you know, I email, and I did this in the email that I sent to you. Just if I go to, I'll use NPR as an example. If you're looking for sources or inspiration and you go to this news site, for example, you're going to get just right in front of you all of the most kind of current immediate news stories. This might not be at all what you're interested in. It might be like too timely of a topic that isn't going to fit very well for a research topic. Again, the idea isn't that you just have to do something that pops up first. So in your email, I just use the very basic example. Maybe you're kind of interested in community colleges. So if I just search community college, all of a sudden, I'm shown all of these articles, all of these recent articles about all different topics involving community colleges. And so then you can kind of delve in and find a topic that might interest you a little bit more. So whether you're doing your journal, whether you're choosing your resources for your research essay, please use that search function. That will be very helpful. And once you get your topic narrowed down a little bit, you can have a more narrow topic. So yeah, keep that in mind. Keep that search function in mind. Okay. So hopefully all of that makes sense. Again, you should have both of these projects underway. The journal we will talk about less and less together, because the idea is as soon as you do get it underway and you get in the swing of things and you figure out a pace that works for you, you are just working on that independently week by week. It's not an assignment that works at the last minute. Neither is the research essay. Both of these assignments are ones that you need to be doing incrementally. I am someone who certainly feels like I do my best writing when I'm under the wire right before deadline. If you feel that way too, just know that that just doesn't work for these assignments. The research essay, maybe you find yourself collecting all of your resources, making an outline, and then writing a first draft, kind of pretending that you're under the wire, but you can't do it all at the last minute. So please be working bit by bit as we work on these projects. Now, the literary analysis. So here you'll find this module just has resources. The individual literary analysis assignments will be embedded within weeks, and not one, it's not the same as the journal and research project where you have kind of this one big project. We'll be working on literary analysis throughout the semester. So here, again, are just some really curated, good resources that you can rely upon throughout the semester. The new assignment you have for this week, as I kind of explained to you all over the last couple of weeks, normally we do an in-class essay early on in Comp 2, where after we've discussed Greasy Lake and where are you going, where have you been, I have students write an in-class comparative analysis of those two stories. This semester, nothing is totally normal, so I decided to do something a little bit different, which works out easier for you. So what I'm asking you to do this week is this new assignment that's posted under week 4. So I will open that up and then refer back. So I'm asking you, and again, you will type this in Word or Google, make sure it's an MLA style, and you'll turn it in as a PDF. But I'm asking you to basically do some just kind of mock pre-writing. Like if you were going to write an in-class essay over these two stories. So the first step for this assignment is to diagnose some literary elements in each story. So here are the elements that I want you to indicate for each story. For this assignment, you also need to refer to these two resources, the detailed and brief handouts for literary elements and analysis. So this is a really great resource that goes into details about all of this terminology. You've heard me use some of these words already in class. So, you know, exposition, how the scene is set. We talked about that with both stories. But this just gives you on paper, virtually, all of these, the terminology that you'll want to kind of hang on to and start feeling comfortable using as you analyze literature. So lots of really great in-depth terminology here. We've talked about some of these already in class, limited omniscience, who the narrator is, a participant or a non-participant, characters. So please look this over. You'll want to start to get feeling comfortable with this terminology. And this is the brief version. So I want you to look over the detailed version, but this brief version will help you with this assignment that you're working on, because I'm just asking you to indicate who or what a few of these things are in each story. So again, for each story, you will indicate who the protagonist is, the point of view, the antagonist, or plural, antagonists, the setting, which is more than place. It's also time, season, era, symbols and meanings. I want you to just have a few that really stand out to you. Don't feel like this needs to be an exhaustive list of every single symbol in the story. Just some that really stand out to you. And then the theme of the story in your own words. What's the author trying to say in this story? So for each story, you'll have just that short list. And then step two is a reflection. A reflection is a more casual and formal writing assignment than an academic essay. So in a short reflection, this just might be a few paragraphs, and that's fine. Describe to me how you might do a comparative analysis of these stories. What's similar? Why? What's different? Why? What stood out to you? And give meaning to your observations. So when we were in class together, we talked about a lot of stuff for both of these stories. I want you to reflect upon things that really stood out to you. And maybe it's something that we didn't touch on at all, but something that if you were going to write an essay dealing with both of these stories, what would you want to focus on? And just write a brief reflection about that. So hopefully that's an assignment that makes sense. And be creative with it. Think of this as just kind of a venture into the world of literary analysis. And you will be writing more formal essays throughout the semester. So again, underneath this link, there are some really helpful links that I will refer to throughout the semester. And then under these top modules that will just kind of stay at the top of the class all semester, week one through three, this was kind of fluid. We went over these links and some of these readings in the first few weeks. And now we'll start to be a little bit more detailed week by week. So week four, here's your literary analysis exercise, which is due Friday by midnight. And if I ever, which I clearly am, but on Canvas, if you're in a Monday, Wednesday class and something is due Thursday or due Friday at midnight, I'm hoping that if something is due not on your class date, it will always kind of benefit you in terms of giving you a little extra time. So just really use your calendar, use Canvas notifications to make sure you're keeping on top of when things are due. And then for the readings week by week, remember on your text list, if there's a page number, that's from your textbook. Otherwise, I will provide you with the readings that I expect you to read. So. Okay, I think that kind of covers some of the main things you should be thinking about right now. Again, getting your journal underway. It's meant to be a meaningful assignment that asks you to kind of stay plugged in and be thinking about writing and ideas and yourself throughout the semester. So please get that underway. And if you have any questions, let me know. I'm also happy to look at what you have so far if you want to make sure that you're on the right track. research essay. This week is the week that you should be kind of firm in your commitment to your argument and really start doing some digging and gathering your resources and, you know, again, being creative and thinking about choosing a topic and committing to a topic that is interesting to you. And please remember the parameters of this assignment are quite broad. This is not a boring report over something that you think will just kind of be easy to gather information about. You can take a topic that you're passionate about or that you're interested in and look at it in a whole new way. And again, if you're still trying to discern and figure out what you'd like to dig into, let me know. I can really be helpful. And then with literary analysis, this is, again, the meat of this course, which we've done quite a bit in class together, or at least gotten started. But I want to start to see you kind of flex some of your developing muscles with literary analysis by the end of this week. Kind of looking with your own eyes at Gracie Lake and Where Are You Going, Where Have You Been, and some things that stood out to you. So remember the wonderful and also sometimes befuddling thing about literary analysis is that as long as you can support your argument with evidence from the text, your analysis can be right. And I think that in our classes, we all experience that, especially with the ending of Where Are You Going, Where Have You Been? There's not one right answer. And that I hope that you're seeing the cool possibilities in that and not just, oh, this is just a bunch of gray area. That's kind of tough. It's exciting. It can be really fun. So start delving in, looking at those handouts, getting comfortable with some of that language, and we will continue to have some really great and hopefully interesting discussions where you bring your own ideas and observations to class. So thank you for making this far. I just wanted to again give an overview of the few things that we will be really focusing on all semester. Please always reach out if you have any questions, either via email or if you want to have a one-on-one Zoom meeting or phone call. I'm always available. Just let me know. Have a great week.